Hi, it's Allie from Allie Answers, and I am grateful you are watching today. We are talking about grief and bereavement. A lot of times when people are considering hospice as an option for their loved one, they're not really looking past the moment that their loved one will leave them. But bereavement is designed to support the family for 13 months after their loved one passes away. Now, that can be important because a lot of people do not have access due to lack of funds or just their location. They don't have access to proper counseling. And so bereavement is fantastic because they come in, they support the family. They usually have built a relationship with the family prior to their loved one's passing, and they can continue that relationship as time goes on. Most of the time, you are going to be talking to people who have been in hospice for many years. They understand the death process and they understand the complicated grief that goes with it. Grieving begins long before we lose someone. When we have a long-term illness that we're dealing with, there is anticipatory grief where a person is already experiencing just the fear of grief, really, and then processing the losses that they have as these different milestones happen. Maybe their loved one can no longer go to family functions or go to church, so they are grieving along the way. Another type of grief is called ambiguous loss. That's really common with dementia, especially. Spouses that are used to depending on their loved ones to guide them, to direct them, maybe to pay all the bills in the house or to make decisions about big things. A lot of times their mind is gone long before their body leaves this world. There is this feeling of grief that a lot of times families will have a hard time putting a finger on. They know that they're in pain. They know that they're struggling with loss, but it's hard to formulate how they're feeling. Social workers and chaplains are uniquely qualified to deal with that type of ambiguous loss. Often you'll find that the caregivers who are coming out to the home to help with showers and bathing leading up to the passing are really good at talking to the family members and supporting them and loving them through the season. Nurses are invaluable in sharing their experience and what to expect with the family members. When considering hospice, please remember that there are a lot of disciplines that are there to support the person who's terminally ill, as well as the family and loved ones that are surrounding them. When someone passes without the benefit of hospice, it also leaves the family without that type of support. If this video was helpful and you're watching it on YouTube, please give me a like and subscribe. It helps other people see this video as well. And I hope you have a fantastic day. Bye.